Sup, dogs?
Hey.
It's all of the excitement you're going to get out of us. Sorry.
Actually, I'm quite excited for this one.
He is pumped. I was telling him about it, but he didn't believe me. And
well, you're like, oh, you gotta try this Howe Sound beer. It's really good. And I'm like, yeah, whatever, Howe Sound. Who cares? And then he's like, oh, here's the Hefeweizen.
Hefeweizen, yeah.
And I'm like, yeah, whatever, and retry it. And yeah, it was pretty good. And then he's like, oh, I gotta try the other Howe Sounds. And I'm like, yeah, whatever. And I pick up this.
The Howe Sound Nut Brown. Bow down.
And my taste buds exploded.
In his face.
And I found my new favorite beer.
Pretty much. And without further ado, we keep that as a souvenir. Splorsh.
So this is the second Howe Sound Brewery beer that we're doing.
It's kind That's of a nice golden brown.
Mm-hmm. Nutty sort of looking.
Sort of kind of.
One thing I have to say is that about the Howe Sound beers is their packaging is very, like, meh. So you're like, well, you know,
Howe like
Sound.
It.
It's just, when I saw it, I'm like, yeah, Howe Sound, whatever. And what's inside the bottle is very different from outside the bottle.
It's true.
Let's try this baby.
Yep. I was drinking this, actually, on New Year's.
This is some good stuff. This is the kind of beer that I can just drink anytime. All the time.
We should just get you a big, long straw.
I don't think I'd drink it out of a straw.
Yep, you got it.
It's sweet, like an ale should be.
Mm-hmm.
It's got this cool flavor that I've never tasted before.
It's like, it's really toasty and... Mm-hmm. and like,
it almost has a bit of, you could almost say, like a nut flavor to it. Like a toasted nut. Like an almond, almost. That's the one I'd use.
Yeah, or maybe a walnut.
Mm-hmm. But it's not bitter like a walnut, though.
No.
It's sweet.
Yeah. I noticed that the beers that we really like, we don't have much to say about.
Or that we really hate.
Yeah. So if you're really, really good or really, really bad, we're not going to talk too much. We're just going to either enjoy or suffer through the beer.
It's a beautiful color.
It is a beautiful color. Like, you can't. I don't think you can really see or really be able to tell. Actually, I have a little bitty flashlight here. But it is a rather nice color, which you probably cannot see. I'm trying my best. I just have no idea how the lighting's going to work when through this camera.
But like you once said, I was rewatching some of the videos. You're like, I don't really care what kind of color it is as long as it tastes good.
Yeah, but this is... Every now and again, you come across something like that, and it just looks good.
And it tastes so good. Oh, yeah. Man. So, this is my new favorite beer. I give it a 10.
Yes.
And I will be drinking it more than any other beer. Very nice. Oh, so good.
It's true.
Damn you for not telling me.
I tried. You weren't listening.
You weren't telling me with enough force.
Fair enough. What do we have to say about the Rail Ale Nut Brown? Smooth, flavorful nut brown ale with hints of chocolate and licorice. Made with 100% barley, hops, water, and yeast. Named in recognition of the region's strong railway tradition and Squamish, BC's West Coast Railway Heritage Park, home of the Royal Hudson, Western Canadian largest collection of heritage railway equipment. They name a lot of their stuff after things. They did a charity beer over the winter, it's called Boomer's Red, which I didn't get a hold of for some weird reason. It was, if you bought it, then they donate like $1 to a charity for this. I think this guy died and they were donating to whatever charity in his name.
Cool.
And,
they also said something about if we came down to their area, we could get a beer tour, but
cool.
I think they're a little bit out of the way.
Yeah. They're down in, Howe Sound.
Howe Sound.
Which is Squamish. Near Squamish, yeah. But if we're ever in the area, aren't you guys going down sometime?
Yeah, we're going down, but then you have to go down and then up. It's just a little bit too much out of the way.
Make time?
Do you make beer for kids?
Yeah. See, if you guys have a playroom, they're there.
No, but This is an amazing beer. I would even say that a person who liked Budweiser or these, you know, iffy sort of beers would probably like this.
They are sketchy, let's be honest.
Like, it tastes good.
Yeah, I mean, the bottom line, great taste. And that's all I'm really looking for out of beer. If it's got a fantastic color, even better. But not something I'm really head up about.
Yeah. 10 out of 10.
10.
For any kind of beer.
Cheers.
Thank you, Howe Sound.
Consistently, I would have to say Howe Sound consistently the best. Every time I've had one of their beers.
I've only had two. This and the Hefeweizen.
But no, I have. I've also had the Winter. The Father John's Winter Ale. Which we probably will review next time. Or the time after. And I've also had the Garibaldi Pale Ale. And Honey Pale Ale.
They got their India Pale Ale?
No.
We'll
I'm still a little suspect. We might not get to the IPAs for a while. Because neither of us are big into the hops.
I don't mind hops, but I'd rather have something like this. With,
yeah.
Like, low on the hops, but whatever.
Yeah. And that's basically all we have to say about it. Go find it. Go buy it. Go drink it.
Mm-hmm. He's good.
And then go buy and drink more. Responsibly.
No driving.